I'm going to show you how to get to the nursing database that we use and show you how to put the regular limiters on the database to find the articles you need for a specific nursing assignment. So I'm starting out at the irsc.edu homepage, and up here under quick links, you can click on libraries to take you to the library homepage. Next, you're going to click databases by subject to get to all of our databases. And then you'll notice that there are subjects listed under here, and I can click on nursing to get to all of the nursing databases. The one that we're going to use is called CINAHL Complete, and it's the best one for this search because it offers all the limiters that you are asked to use in your nursing class to find journal articles. When you click on CINAHL Complete, it's going to ask you to sign in through my Pioneer portal. I believe I am signed in already, so it's taking me straight to the database. But you should be able to sign in with my Pioneer portal credentials. If you have issues, please let the library know by emailing us at library@irsc.edu. So once I am in CINAHL, of course, the first thing you want to do is put in your topic. But for this nursing class, you have very specific limiters you need to put on your search. So you're being asked to find a nursing journal article on a topic that is less than 5 years old, that's published in an American nursing journal, who has one author is at least a nurse, and that the journal is peer reviewed. So I'm going to show you that process down below. The first thing I am going to do is I'm going to limit it to full text. If I don't get any results or I get too few results, I can take off the full text limiter, and then I will find articles that the library maybe does not own, but I can ask the library and borrow them if I find one that works for me. And you would just email us once again, library@irsc.edu, to get any articles that we do not own. So a lot of people just get click happy and start clicking things. We really want to be mindful of the assignment and just select things that we absolutely need. So the very first thing you can limit by is a year. So the last 5 years is standard for nursing journals. Peer reviewed is another one that is normally asked for. And that means that the journal itself sends any original research articles that are printed in the journal through a review process with experts in the field before they publish it. And this is to, you know, not publish misinformation, right? So we have two options for the author. The first author is a nurse, or any author is a nurse. Now, the first author is a nurse means we always list in the articles, the first author is always the main contributor. So we don't list them alphabetically, we list them by how much they've contributed to the article. If your professor does not specify first author needs to be a nurse, any author is a nurse is going to give you more results. So that is a better search for you when you have so many other limiters you need to place on your search. Under journal subset, we can select nursing, and that will eliminate any dental journals rather than nursing journals. And under geographic subset, we are going to select USA, and that will limit it to journals published in the United States. Now, just a note here, even though the journal's published in the United States, the study could take place in another country. The only requirement your professor is asking you to do is to find a journal that's published in the US, not necessarily that the study was done in the United States. So that's something you're gonna have to figure out if it's necessary that it's United States or not when you look at the articles itself. So up here, you should have an actual idea of what you're gonna put in. Usually you have a patient, the patient has some sort of issue, and you're trying to find articles that are gonna help you figure out therapies or ways to help this individual. So you want to be, you know, as loose with these as you can, because you have so many limiters down below. So I'm going to put in hypertension and do search. You can, of course, put in other search words as well, but I just want to see how many I get first. I got 92 results. And for a search in this database with all those limiters, that is a really good set of results. I would or could put in other things such as a location is usually one thing that you might want to put in, hospital, hospice, at-home care, whatever it is, location that you wanted to look at. Another thing you can do is you can put in a geographic location. So if it does matter that it is a United States study, you can put in United States. And you can see how my results changed as I added keywords here. Looking at the results themselves, you'll see the title of the article really gives you exactly what's going to be in the article. It's very descriptive of what is in the article. If you see this full text finder, that means it's finding the article in another database. And that's why I tell you to search CINAHL, because it'll look in other databases for you and you don't have to go to Ovid and search Ovid. You can search CINAHL and get Ovid results. It also gives you subjects. So that can help you decide how you might change your search. So hypertension wasn't cutting it for me. Maybe I really want to focus on something else. Or if you're using an acronym, sometimes if you spell it out, you might get different results. If there's a PDF full text, that means the article is being found in this database. And you want the PDF over an HTML because the PDF will give you things like page numbers where you need that in order to cite it correctly. Once I click on an article, I get additional information about it. And before I actually read the article or save it or use it for my class, I want to make sure that the limiters I placed on it actually brought back the correct results. So the first thing I would do is click on the journal name, and that will tell you where this journal was published. And it says United States of America, so we're good there. I'm going to go back. And you'll notice that I use the buttons within the database rather than up here in the browser. That can really mess up with your searching. So you can read an abstract of the article before you get into the article to decide if it's something that you think will work. And then I'm going to look at the PDF in order to verify that one of these authors listed here actually has a nursing credential, because that is part of what my limiters were and something that I want to double check before I turn it in. So that's where you'll find that information is on the article itself. It'll list the authors and usually list their credentials on that first page. And you can see this is not page one of the journal article. This is page 785. So that's where it comes into play when you're doing direct quotes in APA, you want to use a page number. So the PDF will help. And as you can see, it's a scan of the article. It even gives you pictures, which is not always the case. Over here on the right-hand side are some options where you can email the article to yourself. So even if this article is not quite what I want, but maybe it sort of fits, I might email it to myself so I don't have to find it again. And then also what you want to do here is you want to send yourself the APA style citation. That's going to help you a great deal when it comes to writing your paper. You're not going to have to figure out how to make this journal article into APA. This little yellow piece of paper also gives you the citation if you prefer to grab it this way. You just want to make sure you're using the correct one because they list more than one citation style here. Here's the APA. I can copy and paste it into my paper. And then I have the article and the APA when I email it to myself.